Yay!
It's Jeremy Facknitz. It's not Jeremy Facknitz or Facknitz or what the kids called me at school, like what I should describe myself as. He said deeply personal folky rock tunes dressed in vintage clothing. I was like, okay, I like that. And I do have some pretty personal stuff. And it's good that this is an intimate crowd, because there might be some moments tonight where you're like, Jeremy, that's just too much information. I didn't need to know that. But I write straight out of my journal. So it's okay. We'll all be friends by the end of the night. We're all friends right now. I know everybody here. This is a pragmatic love song. It's not like those teeny bopper songs you hear about forever. This was written in my 30s, after I had been through a few forevers. And so it's more pragmatic, it's a little bit more realistic. Your hair so pretty and your eyes so blue. Well, it's no wonder all I do is twist and shout. And if I'm not mistaken, you've been dancing too. Hey, Lindsay, have you seen my breath? I think it ran off with yours to leave us here alone. So I can love you till there's nothing. Sing out my name in your velvet tones. Yes, you sing my name in your velvet tones. Last night we talked until the sun came up, sharing coffee cup confessions of shame and sin. We spoke of others, we loved us, we gave ourselves up, yes we did. And then we closed our eyes so we could rush right here. Hey Lindsay, let's just share this breeze. Winds are calling, we can take it slow. And still together long as we both please. And should we ever feel it's best we go, I will still love you, and I think we know our minds. So before we waste more time, let's step back and think this over. See, pragmatic. Let's pause here. Talk so cool, at least I do my best. Logic and reason are some damn good friends. Yeah, but this ain't logic beating in my chest. This ain't logic beating out of my chest. Whoa. Hey Lindsay, have you seen my breath? I think you ran off with yours too. Take me over. many love songs. I feel like a lot of it's been said enough, you know, but I'll play another one later. I'm gonna jump into a couple songs here before I tell you more about me. So I've been taking voice lessons. This is really just kind of interesting. Taking voice lessons for 3 years. One of my bad habits before I took voice lessons was I wasn't really breathing. I wasn't really on the breath. Can we see your tattoo on your arm there? Breathe. Isn't that great? You can just hold your arm there the whole night. I appreciate that. I noticed that. I was like, yeah, that's right. Breathe, Jeremy.
Tattoo.
Harmless, but there's no stopping him. All the kids, they stare, but no one else who passes seems to care. He's there, sharing all the wisdom of a man who's lost his mind on me. She was planning on it, but we started dating just for fun. After 3 months, she's crying. She's like, oh, I'm going to miss you so much. And I said, you know what? I'm going to move to Boston. We've only been dating 3 months, but I'm going to move to Boston. We'll live in a studio apartment because it's real expensive in Boston. It's going to be great. She never asked me to move with her. I just jumped in. So yeah. Boston was difficult. I lived there for a year and a half, and it was very challenging. It wasn't just the Nor'easters. The people are different and a little bit harder, probably due to the Nor'easters. And I had a real hard time there. And when I left, I actually wrote this like nasty song about Boston. Like,
bye bye Boston, you're not worth the rent you're costing.
It was really like, you know, whatever, you know. But that wasn't doing anybody any good. Boston didn't care that I hated Boston. And I was just like carrying around this hate. So after about 3 years of living in beautiful, sunny, awesome, friendly Colorado Springs, Colorado, I went back to Boston on tour. I was scheduled to headline at Club Passim on open mic night. And I thought, you know what? I'm going to go back to the scene of my dismal time. I'm going to go back to the brownstones right there on Charles Gate and Boylston, right over the right field fence of Fenway Park, and just confront the darkest time of my life. And I went there, and I was like walking around. I'm like, okay, no big deal. I can do this. And there was a baseball game that night. The Red Sox were playing the Angels. It's really close to Fenway Park. So I'm like, I'm going to walk around the park a few times, and then I'm just going to go to my gig. And this is cool. I'm glad I'm here. Because even just going to the scene of that, it was hard for me. And I'm walking around the stadium, and all of a sudden I hear, hey, you want a ticket? And I'm like, scalper. I'm like, I don't have any money. He's like, no, I just want to give it to someone who appreciates it. I'm like, what? Okay, thanks, you know, and that's, I'm a big baseball fan, so I was like, that's great, you know, and his buddy says, yeah, you know, we have these, like, food vouchers, too. We have $60 worth of food vouchers. You can't buy beer, but you can buy Cracker Jacks and hot dogs. It's yours. We just want to give it to somebody who will appreciate it, and I was like, thank you so much, and he goes, hey, man, Jesus loves you. I'm like, yes, he does. I'm going to a baseball game. And I went in there, and I was like, so I was flying high, and you would think that maybe in this spiritual moment, I'd pay it forward and hand out some, like, food tickets to kids. I bought 5 bags of Cracker Jacks. I bought 2 hot dogs. I ate it all. And I sat there in my seat, and I don't know what happened in the game. It was an offensive. It was a slugfest. It didn't really matter. But, if you've ever seen a Red Sox game, in the 8th inning, they sing Sweet Caroline by Neil Diamond. And so when that time came, I went down behind home plate, and I just sat there, and I went arm in arm with, like, strangers, and I sang Sweet Caroline. And it was, like, such a beautiful moment. It was like I came back to, like, just face what was a horrible time in my life, and it was totally reframed into this magical human experience. And so I went home, and I wrote this. I wrote half of this, and I cried like a baby, and I wrote the other half. So, I had to mention the crying like a baby. I make sure I'm in tune, though. I want to make sure that I'm in tune. This is that B string, you know?
Your hotels and your record stores, urban rhythms, sound the call to war. I don't have a gun, just armed with the sun set upon my back. Wearing new shoes to retrace my tracks. I'll make my peace with Boston, make my peace with me.
I said, baby, let's clean my
Caroline, and good times never felt so good. La 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 la. Looks like we just made up. I say, Boston, let's clean my slate. From the gun corps behind home plate, when I'm calling strike three on the hate. And she said, friend of mine, so good to see that your light still shines. And we sang our sweet Caroline. I say, Boston, let's clean my slate. From a gun board behind home plate, yes, some call on strike three on a hate. She said, friend of mine, so when I see that your light still shines, and we sang our sweet Caroline, and good times never felt so good. Something in the way that she moves attracts me like no other lover. Something in the way she woos me. Well, I don't wanna leave her now. You know I believe in her. Something a style that shows me. Well, I don't wanna leave her now. You know I believe in her. You're asking me, will my love grow? Something in the way that she knows. All I have to do is think of her. Something in the things she shows me. Well, I don't wanna leave for now. You know I believe in her. Thank you.